What's going on, guys, from YouTube? All right, so for today's video, I got a 2004 F-150. This is what the front end looks like. If you guys notice, there's a big opening right there. What we're gonna do on this truck, we are installing a 22-inch aux beam Cree light bar. It has 43-watt Cree LEDs, I believe. I think it's 40. 120 watts, 12,000 lumens. The total length of this is 22 inches. That's literally edge to edge. Give about a half an inch for brackets, so you got 22 and a half. The full opening the full opening for this hole is roughly around 32 inches. You guys notice inside of there, it's got those plastic I don't know, just like covers, I guess. So the opening on the inside of that is at roughly 21 inches. So we're gonna have to cut about a 3/4 to an inch right in the center almost of this to give way for the light bar to kind of go recessed in there. And also, there's already some brackets to the bumpers right behind there. I don't know if you guys can see those. We're gonna use those as mounting locations. Up against from here, if you guys notice, clearance, you got about 3 inches. So we're gonna have the bar coming out maybe about right here, not sticking out too far, but also not recessed too far in to where it kind of hides in the background. Also, we will be installing a pair of these, I believe these are 5-inch recessed lights, just like that, in this grill here. And if you guys notice, the grill kind of, it comes out like this and then it curves in, so we're gonna squeeze them in between here and the Ford emblem. But you got about a clean 7 to 8 inches of somewhat flat surface right there, so that's where we're gonna put it, one on each side. We're gonna get them dead center to the top and bottom to where they don't look too high or too low. So I think dead center, or I don't know, we're gonna have to get a better look at this and see if, along with the owner's son, if we decide to go maybe a little bit higher, we'll see. But that's where they're gonna go. The 22 inch light bar, this is what you get when you order that. It has the mounting brackets with the rubber little grommets. So basically, you don't do metal to metal. It gives you a nice protection against hard vibrations. Also, it also keeps your either paint from getting more damaged. You got your bolts, your Allen. But what we're gonna do is we're not gonna use this. What I did, I somewhat made some modified brackets, similar to the brackets that I made for the WRX on my previous video. I'll leave the link to that on the description if you guys want to check that one out. But it's almost the same thing. So what I did, I mounted some 1.5-inch flat bar, did a couple of holes right here for bolting up against that bumper frame that I was telling you guys about. I brought this out, measured roughly 6 inches to here, and then I did an inch back. I did 2 more holes, inch and an inch, in case we decide to go further back. If we decide to use this hole or this hole, then I'm gonna notch off the front of this and then I'm gonna round it off. But how this is gonna set, I don't know if you guys can see it back there, but we're gonna bolt that into that frame. So in turn, it's gonna leave perfect area for us to bolt the light bar to. So we're gonna get to that. First, I'm gonna measure some stuff up. Also, I'm gonna see about relocating this license plate, if it's gonna be too much of a deal. I don't know, I'm thinking maybe somehow just flipping this upside down to where the license plate is top part, like right around that chrome area. I'll see. I mean, the worst thing that's gonna happen, we're gonna have to make like some kind of an extension to bolt up to the bumper, but we'll figure that out. Right now I'm gonna mark where I'm gonna cut. I'm gonna use my Dremel to cut those plastic pieces and start forming. All right, guys, so the first step is removing the license plate and license plate bracket. How this is on here, if you guys notice back here, it's got a clip right there, a clip right here, a clip right here, and a clip right here. So basically what you're gonna be doing first is you pull up on here and you push out, and then it comes undone like that. Inside here, if you guys notice, the clip, it's slid on there. You have to go in from the underneath, lift up on the lower valance, and pull these little clips up. And pull these little clips up to where they're even. And so as soon as that happens, it slides right out. Do it up to both sides. The whole piece comes right off. So now we have the whole area to come and work on. Also, one other thing. Upon inspecting this, I noticed that these little pieces come right off. They're also just clipped in with that right there, one up here, and then they slide on this side. So if you guys can see, they slide in there, clip on the bottom and clip on the top. So just undo this side and then slide it out. So we did that to both of these. Now we have the full opening right here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bolt up the light bar in place first, and then I'm just going to trim these little pieces a little bit at a time until I get a nice snug fit. It pops back in and it has the little notched out area. So we'll do that. For the top lights, what I did, if you guys notice, I just kind of set a marking point of where I'm going to put them. And I did this just by taping up the little honeycomb slots. I tested my Dremel to make sure I was going to be able to get a cut, so it works. Now I'm just going to determine, we want them this far, this as far as width. Now we're going to determine exactly, roughly, now we're going to determine where we want them height-wise. Alright guys, so we're just test fitting the light bar on here. If you guys notice my brackets that I made, on this side we have them on the center of the three holes. We feel like that's the perfect distance for the light bar to be sticking out. As you can't see it, if it's like flush down like this, it's perfect. As an example, I put this side right at the very last one, 6 inches. If you guys notice, if you guys look down, you just can see it. I feel like it sticks out just a little bit too much. So we're gonna go ahead and go with the center hole. If I put it in the one all the way in the back, we feel like it kind of gets lost a little bit in that depth. So we're not gonna do that. We're gonna leave it in the center, just like that right there. And I'll give you guys a measurement right now of how far it is to center of that bolt from the actual bracket. Also, if you guys notice those brackets I made back, when it comes to back here, they fit right in. So now I just got to make a hole, two holes right where those holes are at, drilled on the flat bar. I got to cut into the frame, or not the frame, it's like a bumper mount. I got to drill the 5/16 holes into that, bolt that up. With two bolts, I think it should be strong enough to hold the weight of this light bar, which is not a lot. And I think we can just continue on cutting the pieces on the sides to finish this off, and then we'll run our electrical. Alright guys, so I got the brackets reduced down to the two holes, rounded them off. One thing I didn't mention, and I probably should, is when you're making a set of brackets for a light bar like this, what you want to do is when you put them together and you have the flat side, like, you know, against the surface like that, clamped down, make sure you put these next to each other and then weld it right here, or clamp it really, really good, and then drill your holes that way. That way the holes are always perfectly matched up. See? Because what happens is, if you think that you get the measurement right and you mark each one at a time and then you drill the hole, by the time you do that, even if you're off by a hair, you'll be able to notice on the light bar if it's not even. As long as, assuming that you got these bolted on evenly. So one thing to always do is tack these in place, drill the hole through both pieces at the same time. That way you get a good hole that's exactly in the same spot as the opposite side. All right, guys, so jumping into the lights for the grill. In the meantime, I'm painting. I had those brackets, I touched them up with some heavy duty paint. So those are drying. What you want to start by doing to mount these in, you want to check the clearance for the light. If you guys notice, that's about a 3 1/8. I'm gonna cut at 3 1/4, just so I have a little bit of adjustment sideways. If you guys notice, this in this direction, it's exactly 2 7/8. So I'm gonna cut right at 3 inches. So 3 inches tall, 3 1/4 inches wide. So then now you're gonna, I would probably use a point of interest. I'm thinking, like, me, it'll be the very edge of the little diamond. So that'll be my measuring points. Actually, no, I'm gonna try to get right in the middle of both of the little zigzagging lines. I'm gonna try to get right in the center. So that'll be my marking points. So I'm gonna measure 3 1/4, 3 down. Alright guys, so we determined the height and the area of width between center to center of each light that we liked. We went 3.5 inches from the bottom of the grill down to the center. So I made my line right there, 3.5 inches on both sides. Then I went up and down 1.5 inches, so you have 3 inches of height. And then remember how I said I was going to use a little zigzagging center line as a marker? That's what my marker is right there. I went 3 1/4 out, 3 1/4 out, made my marking. So that's where we're going to cut our holes. Also, just, you know, always verify visually to see, make sure that you're going to get all the clearances that you need. That looks good right there. And I'm aiming for a tight fit, because you can always cut a little bit more. It's better to cut a little bit and then more later than a lot at once, and then this won't fit or it's too loose. There's no areas for you to bolt it up to. There's a bunch of things that could go wrong, so always double check before you cut. That's the number one rule in almost anything that has to do with manufacturing. Measure twice, cut once. So let me go ahead and start cutting that up. All right, guys, so a little bit of tuning. I took my Dremel, put the sanding disc on. Does not look pretty, that's just because it's the tape. So don't, if you guys get all jagged like that, the tape is all torn apart, but if you guys remove it, that's what you're left with. It looks ugly, yes, I know, but you gotta understand that this is not perfect squares, so you are not gonna get a nice looking square. But once you put the light in place and the recess is in there, it kind of all just goes away. You know, it looks like everything's fine, you just inserted the light. So if you guys notice, this is a really tight squeeze. It's nice and snug, but if you guys notice that, if you guys could see right here, it looks like it's dropping just a hair on this side than on this side. So I'm gonna have to go in here and sand off the honeycomb on this corner and on this corner on the back, so I could tilted just a hair. So it's little details like that that make your install look professional or not. So make sure you look for that. But I'm gonna move on to the next one, and then we'll kind of stand back and eyeball them and see if we need to do slight adjustments. If you guys notice, the bolt would not fit in there, because you guys can see very tiny little piece of that honeycomb in the back. That tells me that it needs to go up, because this side, if I eyeball this way, it's this one clears real good. So alright guys, so once you have the light in place where you want it, I'm going to show you guys what we're going to do here. I'm going to take a pencil or a pen and mark right where that line, where the bracket is at. And you want to make little markings throughout the whole light. Because what we're going to be doing, if you guys notice how the grill is kind of facing up a little bit, what we're going to be doing is, we're going to be shaving off from the markings in only on the bottom half, so that this light recesses in there a little bit better, and it gives you closer to a 90 degree pitch. So we're probably gonna knock off, I'm gonna start with 3/16 off at the bottom right here, all the way only to the lines, not further. Alright guys, so my Dremel is charging right now, so I'm gonna put the sides, those little lights aside. So the brackets are already touched up with some black paint. I am using some cardboard to kind of hold it in the slot. I'm checking the level of this truck. You guys can see it's, I don't know if you got there, it's pretty good. I mean, it's off a little bit, so you want to have that exact measurement on your bar. So you guys can see it is almost identical right there, so we know that we have it height wise on both sides. It's good. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mark the holes that are right there, and then I'll drill a hole right where the where that's at. So there's one, then the other two are right here. That's two, and then I'll drill those in with the drill and be able to bolt that in. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is when I see my marking, I'm going to go ahead and do a center punch, one of these tools. Kind of uses, it uses to mark the center of a hole, that way you don't, your drill bit doesn't go all over the place. So there it is, it's ready to be drilled. Do the same thing to that side again once I have the two holes, but first I'm only do one side only on each bracket in case I screw up the slots a little bit. I have the other hole to be able to get right once these are bolted in place. Alright guys, so I got the bar in place just by bolting up the rear, the side bolts on this. One thing to know, if when you install it and you bolt it up and it looks all twisted up, don't worry too much. Just make sure you get it centered. What I did on this one, you guys can, I left it out so you guys can kind of see it. That little silver piece is this little washer. So I used that as a shim, so I could pivot this corner up a little bit, tightened it up. Now if you guys can see, it's right where we wanted it to be. So, well, right now the owner's in and out of the truck, but it's right where we wanted it to be. So that's how it looks. Now we get to drill out the other two holes and bolt them up nice and strong, that way it doesn't go anywhere, and then proceed to filling in this piece with the plastic cover. Alright guys, so we got both of the bolts on this side. You guys can see them in the back, both of the bolts on this side. If you look up here, you'll see them straight through the frame or the bumper bracket. I keep calling it frame, I'm sorry for that. This one here. What I did on this one on the left, it actually, the hole was right on, it has a big factory hole right here. So what I did, I put a bigger washer and then I put the smaller washers in and then locked it up that way. So it's nice and strong like the rest of them. And so this one, we're technically ready to proceed the wiring. For wiring, I'm going to use the same kit as I've been using on most of my videos. However, this one, I'm thinking of changing out the switch to these little toggle switches. So I'll show you guys how to do that. What I'm going to do now, I think my Dremel should be ready and charged. So I'm going to start trimming these plastics up against there, make sure they're nice and snug. I will do one more time before I do this though, is I'm going to take off the light bar and I'm going to touch up the brackets, make sure that everything's nice and painted before I proceed to doing anything else. But let me do that first and then I'll start cutting these up. All right guys, so one last thing before we fully mount this bar, what I'm going to do is I'm going to touch up these brackets. I want to make sure I get all the areas nice and covered with paint, that way there is no rust coming through that steel or any kind of mainly rust. Let me see, just want to make sure you either cover up the stuff that you want covered so you don't get any over spray on it, and then just shoot it. So now it's ready. We'll just let this dry for a minute. Now proceed to the little lights on the grill. All right, guys. So I got the left side of that little cover back in. I don't know if you guys can see it right there. What I did on that, I measured from here to the very tip of this. It was 5 inches. Then I just kind of set the piece in there on this side and marked it the top and the bottom of the angle, I mean of the flat bar. And then I just made a quick little marking. See, this is for the left side, for the left side. And so this is the right side, this is the left side. Then what I did, once I figured out where I wanted it, I drilled out some holes on the corners just so that you don't have an ugly cut mark if you, when you try to go over those two joining lines. I don't know if you guys can see right there how that's gonna give me my measurement. So now I'm just gonna go with the either grinding wheel or the Dremel. I'm gonna cut that right out, and then you just insert it back in. All right guys, so I got the piece cut out, very nothing to it, just with the cutting wheel. So I'll show you guys, just inserted that in right inside the little slot. I gotta push these back in. Snaps in place. Now just gotta push it until there. And that bottom one's snap and then the top one just snap. So there it is. It's back to its original position. Just with that minor notch for the light, for the bracket, I mean. And it's ready. So the whole bottom is ready, except we just gotta mount the license plate. And you gotta wire it up. That's where it did go. All right guys, so I already ran the cables under the engine compartment. I'll show you that in a minute, but I wanted to show you how to get rid of these pesky on-off switches that nobody seems to like. So on your connector, what you have is you have the three wires, white, red, and black. Black being obviously power. Ground. I don't know what I was thinking. So the black one obviously being ground. White and red are both power. Even though you know that red is power, and you'd wonder what this is. Well, this is also power. But the thing is that it's actually making a loop through the switch. When you switch the from red to green to on, it actually just makes a connection that gives
the red cable, the ability to turn power back onto the white cable and turn ghost to the lights. So don't trip that you could remove one wire. Just like I said, this is simply just to be able to turn this light on, the little on and off light. Other than that, all this switch is just a connection between the red and the white one that gives you connection and no connection. That's really it. So we're using these little toggle switches that have only two little prongs. That's what I was saying, because I've used some that have three that lights up a very faint light, and when I ordered these, I thought that's what these were, but they don't have the light. But these are just plain on off. So you got two little prongs, little male connectors, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna cancel out this black one because we're not gonna need this to light up, you know. So this no cables. So what you do is you cut these off, and I'm gonna cut them off like right around here, because I want, just in case I can use this on another project, I could still use this with butt connectors. So now all you're gonna do is on this, you're gonna splice that out. You're gonna fit one of these little female connectors in, one on each side, and then those you're gonna plug straight into here. All right, guys, so I determined that what I wanted to do was run them right in here. And so what I did, I found a spot on this panel. I drilled out two three-quarter inch holes right there. And I was able to squeeze them in right between this gap right here. So once you connect the female connectors, all you do is just plug these right in like that, and you have your on-off switches. So let me do that real quick. I'm gonna put the panel back in, and then we'll proceed to finishing off under the hood. All right, guys, so the buttons or the switches are on. You can see them right there. On. You can kind of see the glare kick on. Off. On, off. So you see it working. What I did, since I'm putting the grill and bumper lights, bottom one is going to mean bottom light, top one is going to mean top lights. So it's kind of obvious, that way you don't have to mark on here what's what. You know right off the bat that the lower one is the one on the bumper and the top one's on the one on the grill. So let's proceed to the one, to the wiring on the hood, which is pretty much almost done. All right, guys, so we're done, completely done with the light bar on the bumper. I'm going to show you guys what I did on this grill here. I don't know if you guys could see right there how I actually notched the bottom mostly. If you guys notice, this is right here is just a hair, but down here it's about 3/8 of an inch. And the reason why I did that is so that if you guys notice the angle that it used to have before, when this was fully up flat against the grill, see, it's kind of pitched up a little bit. So now it has a little bit straighter aim. If you guys notice, the bottom recesses against that, and then the side, the top, is sticking out. It's not that bad. It looks really nice, actually, in person. So it's not that bad. It's not that hard to do that. You can see right here the notch happened. It's hard to see what I'm talking about, but I mean, you guys could definitely just leave it alone. Plus, these lights are mainly, this customer wants them mainly for the looks. I had asked him about putting a hidden light bar in the back, but he said he was fine. He saw the ones that Oxbeam sent me for my truck, and he liked those. So that's why I got him these. So
I'm gonna mount these up. I already have the wiring ran. Let me show you guys how I did that. All right, so I ran both my relays, my wiring kits right here. Like I mentioned earlier, if you wanna see how to run this wiring kit and how to plug it in, I'll have a link on my video on the description for my Silverado installation. That one I go step by step. So then I ran the cable, the wiring loom down through here, in through here, out through here, and then down to the light bar. Completely out of view, you don't see it. What I did for the top one, I actually ran the other one straight up through here. I drilled some holes on the heat guard, see, and then just wrapped the loom around there. That way I wouldn't have to drill any holes into the existing steel or the hood. Then I ran a couple of zip ties by drilling some holes onto that plastic cover for the shield. Jumped it over to this. Drilled a small hole right above the Ford emblem. Right there. One zip tie. That's to hold the whole wiring in place. And now it's just a matter of finishing this up. I'll have the wiring connections right here. So I'm gonna cut these probably for the light, probably in half. Run a male connector, finish that off. But what I'm gonna show you guys what I did, if you guys notice how you got big gaps on this where the bolts are supposed to be. Alright, so since I didn't get the four bolts that come with this light, I ended up using some bolts. And this is what I did. I cut a piece of plastic, drilled holes right across from it, and drilled them up with a quarter inch. No, those are 5/16 holes. That way they're hugged up against the grill real nice and tight. This one's already done. So this is what I did right here. I finished it off with the male connectors. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tape it up real good. And I'm gonna extend this wiring loom all the way to the light. This is what I used to make those brackets. It's this plastic here. So all I did was use pretty much like that. Transfer the markings over to the plastic, drill the holes just like that. Then I used a cutting wheel to cut them like that. This is what I ended up with. And I just touched them up with black paint, both sides. So now they work out really good. They're 1/4 inch thick, so they're nice and strong. So that's how I did on that. So you have your light. This will be on the opposite sides, basically sandwiching in the grill, and the bolts tightened up. It's not going anywhere. So let me finish this up, wire that up, and that's pretty much it. All right, guys. All right, so we're done. Got the wiring done on this grill. You guys notice, put the wiring loom all throughout the cables, make sure they're nice and covered. Everything is bolted up. Got the bolts going through. One thing to consider, depending on your truck, always make sure that you have the clearance like this in this direction for the lights not to ever hit in this area. I mean, usually it's plenty of clearance, but just in case. Also, make sure this nice and the loom is nice and loose, because as you'll see right now, when we make connection right inside there, it's already touching the radiator support. So by the time we close this, you want to make sure that that's not tight, so when you do that, it doesn't tear the cables off of the light. So that's one thing to remember. Little details like that that can actually ruin your installation if you're rushing through it or not paying any attention.
but they're pretty much done. So we're gonna do a night video right now. It's already a little bit dark. Still, I mean, for these lights, you'll be able to get a good view for them already. So that's how they came out. So let's get these lights on. All right, guys. So we're pretty much done, but I almost forgot that I had to relocate the license plate. So before I turn those lights on, I'm gonna show you guys what I did. So these are the clips that were on this license plate frame. Cut those right off. Right there. And then also on the bottom there, cut off. What I did, I flipped this up. It used to be like that, sitting up high. I'm flipping it up. And we're going to set it right there on that chrome. So I drilled out these holes right here. Those are 1/4 inch. We're going to find the center, which we already did. We transfer punched some holes right where that's at. So you can kind of see the indentation right there, but that's where I'm going to do the holes. And then I'm going to try to do self-tappers at first. If I can't get them nice and tight, then I'm going to have to bolt them on. But I can get my hand through the back, so then we'll just bolt this on only. And then we can still put the license plate, slide it in the slot, and bolt it down with using the original setup. So give me a minute, and I'll show you guys how that's all done. All right, guys. So nothing to it. A couple bolts. We ended up bolting this piece up to the chrome bumper, and then you can easily remove and adjust or change out your license plate frame. So it's all done. Now we're completely done. Lights are up. So I'm gonna back this truck out, and we're gonna kick these puppies on. All right, guys, so here's the truck with its original lights on. This is what you get. We're about to kick those on. Way more light, a lot more. That's how those look. All right, now we're gonna kick on the light bar. And we, as you can tell, we actually fired it down so that this customer actually rides a lot in the country roads. So he wants it for visibility closer to him. Also, so he can drive it without people flashing their lights at him. Yeah, no, it's off-road only, so you guys gotta remember that too. All right, so that's with the 22-inch aux beam light bar with a Cree 40-inch Cree lights. It is really nice light, it's really bright. So you guys can see. If this was aimed in the direction somewhat straight, this would be way brighter. And you could see further out. I'll show you guys right now. We'll pull up to the street, but that's how it comes out. That's how the front end looks now. Hey guys, that's before. That's with standard lights. That's with the light bar. And that's with all the little fog lights. So, I mean, he gets a lot more visibility throughout the neighborhood. There it goes, guys. 22-inch aux beam LED light bar.